Who is that? Okay, that's Lynn. What is up, everyone? Welcome and or welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new, welcome. My name is Mara. Thank you so much for stopping by. We like to grow hair here on this channel, so definitely make sure you subscribe and make sure you hit that notifications button so you don't miss out. So today is the long-awaited video. I feel like all of my hair growth challenges, because they go for months, it's always like long-awaited videos or... Yeah, so the long-awaited video is here. I'm so sorry this is coming to you guys a little late. It's December 6th, but a girl gotta work to get them coins, okay? And I feel like I'm literally doing so many things at once. Like, I can't keep up, so I'm busy. But like I said, this video is on the result to our two-month, not one, but two-month hair growth challenge with the Sulfur 8 Do Grow and Wild Growth Oil. So let's just get right into it. Okay, so like I said, a little bit of background. You guys know that we started this hair growth challenge October 1st, and I put up a video, I believe November 1st, and I honestly did not see any change to my hair. So we extended it for an additional month. So it went from October 1st to December 1st, and it was just 2 months flat. So like I stated in the beginning video, I've been seeing this challenge everywhere. Literally, I've seen it on Google, TikTok, Instagram, YouTube, everywhere. And it's like I kept repeatedly seeing it, and you guys know I'm obsessed with just growing my hair in general, but also making my natural hair as healthy as I can get it. And as long as I can get it, to see if it can grow fast. You know we about that life, okay? So that's what my focus was. So I was like, why not do this challenge? I looked into it and I got the ingredients and we started it. So if you guys don't know what the Sulfur 8 challenge is, you take Sulfur 8. I got the blue kind. They have the yellow kind, which is also medicated. I'm gonna let y'all know it smells awful, but the yellow kind is also medicated. I believe they look the exact same. Fluorescent yellow. I had the blue Do Grow, which I believe is also for length, and then I mixed it with the Wild Growth hair oil. So essentially that's what the mixture is, and people literally everywhere were saying that they grew their hair inches in a couple of months. Me, my mom being a cosmetologist, she has a cosmetology license and she did hair for years. She did my hair. I know that there is no possible way that you can grow multiple inches in a single month or multiple months, because your hair, I believe, is only supposed to grow 1/4 of an inch a month or 1/2 of an inch a month or something like that. Don't quote me. I'm not a cosmetologist. I'm not licensed. I just know from my own experience and from what I read and from what she tells me. But I've been seeing claims where people, their hair went from here to here in like 2 months and 1 month. Logically, like if you think about it logically, that's not possible if your hair only grows 1/4 of an inch normally. Yes, there are other ways to have your hair grow faster, but that fast, if that was the case, everybody would have hair all the way down to the neighbor's yard, okay? I just didn't believe those claims, but I did believe that it would grow your hair at a faster rate. So a little bit about the Sulfur 8. Like I said, it is medicated, both the yellow container and the blue container. This is a light formula. The yellow smells worse, but I guess the light formula is just not as thick as the regular kind. I honestly don't know the difference. I really didn't look into it because I feel like they're both the same. But what I've read is that a lot of people, they did use Sulfur 8 because it cures or treats dandruff. And if you were like me, I had a ringworm and a lot of my hair did come out in the middle. Y'all, I was bald in the middle for some month, and now I'm left tenderheaded, which I don't believe we used when my hair came out, but that's what it's supposed to do. So essentially it's a scalp treatment to help repair your scalp if you have like any irritations, if your scalp is damaged, and etc. So me being me, we're gonna start off with the cons of this hair growth challenge. So the first is the color. Like I said, it's a bright fluorescent yellow. It looks like a highlighter, and things like that, it just kind of, it irks me a little bit because it's not a normal color. The only time when you see like neon colors is when you see it on TV and it's just like they're working in a lab and like stuff that is not supposed to be consumed or it's not supposed to be touched by the human hand or something like that. That's just a personal thing for me. I don't know if it bothers you guys, but the second thing is the smell. This one doesn't smell as bad as the original. It smells bad, but not as bad. So if you're thinking about doing the challenge, or if you did the challenge, then you know. But if you're thinking about doing it, then you also have to take into consideration the smell. My third con is that it's a thick grease. If you think about it, the thicker the product that you're putting on your scalp, the harder it is, I feel, for your scalp to absorb it. Not only is your scalp not absorbing the thick product, but you're wasting product because it's just getting on your pillow, especially if you do a protective style. Like, I did the braids for a month and I applied this and most of the formula or the mixture was on my pillowcase or on my satin scarf rather than being on my head, because the formula is just, it was thick. The fourth con for me is that it itches. Okay, the first day I applied it, I believe that night I started itching, if I remember correctly. If it wasn't that night, it was the next day, and I told you guys that it itched. It just makes you itch. Like, after a few days it goes away. After more applications, you don't even recognize it, you don't even notice it anymore. But after that day and I started itching, like, you would have thought, if I stood beside you, you would have thought that I had fleas, because I was just itching all over. And for me, if my scalp is itching, I start thinking that maybe I do have something on me and it's a bug and they're biting me, so I start itching all over. The fifth con, this is something that I've struggled with, and this is something that I didn't want to add to my struggle, but in my previous videos I've mentioned that I have really bad product buildup. So essentially, product buildup is the buildup of product. So if you think about it, conditioner, you're not supposed to put it on your scalp. It's a hair treatment. It's supposed to help your hair become more manageable. It's supposed to help with the tangles, with the softness and everything like that. So I try not to get conditioner on my scalp because I know that I do suffer with product buildup. Like, I can tell, I can see it. So I try not to let the conditioner touch, but there is a few days where I wash my hair in the conditioner and the conditioner touches my scalp. And it's like, after I rinse out that conditioner, it just lingers. So I would have like a white film or like a white layer of product of conditioner in my scalp, and it'll be like in the front as well on my scalp underneath my hair. And it's like, I just have to like scrape it out with my fingernails. Because I applied this mixture so much the past 2 months, my product buildup was on 10. Like, you guys see the length of this nail? That's how much product was underneath my nail. Like, I was just scratching. I told y'all it itched. I'm scratching, and I have product that I've applied 2 days before, and I applied some today, and I'm just scratching because it itches, and my whole nail is just like covered in product. So those were the only cons that I've noticed from this challenge, aside from anything to do with like the hair growth portion aspect of it. Let's get into the pros. So because you do have the Sulfur 8, the Do Grow, and the oil mixture, it is a very moisturizing mixture. I'm not going to lie to you guys. It really did moisturize my hair. Like, I feel like my scalp was never dry, and I do suffer with dry hair. My scalp was never dry, and when I hopped in the shower, you can tell, like, just the feel of your scalp, just the feel of the hair, and like closer to your scalp, it was more moisturized than the hair that's along the length and closer to the ends. The next pro that it helps with is dandruff. I don't personally suffer with dandruff, but if you are someone who suffers with dandruff, who have suffered with dandruff and is still suffering with it, it may be good for you if you look into it. I wouldn't recommend doing it every day, every other day, probably once a week. My camera's about to die. I know it's about to turn off. Oh my God. Another pro, which is obviously the stem of this challenge, is that it's supposed to help promote hair growth. Another thing that it's supposed to help with as a pro is that it adds thickness to your hair. I feel like I've seen the thickness part of it, and I'll tell you why in a few. Okay, so on to my experience. We did this for 2 months. In the beginning, you guys know, we started October 1st, which was a Thursday. I did my box braids on October 6th, which was a Tuesday, because I was off. I remember I worked the weekend, so I couldn't. I couldn't do my box braids the day that we started. During that time that I did my box braids, I was applying it every 2 to 3 days. I would also apply it every 4 days sometimes, just because it was thick and I already had product on my scalp. And I felt like at the time it was just too much. So I went 2 to 3 days, sometimes 4 days. And then, yeah, whenever my scalp was dry or I just felt like applying it, that's how I did it. The itching, like I said, it was so bad in the beginning. And it's just, I don't know. Because of the itching, I'm not sure if I would go back to it. I don't know where I left off because I've been sitting here for 20 minutes while my camera charges. But to sum this challenge up in terms of hair growth, I would say that this is a fail. Actually, I wouldn't necessarily call it a fail. I would say that the hype surrounding this mixture, it's honestly too overrated, because people are saying, like I said, they're claiming that they're growing X amount of inches, and logically that's just not possible for you to grow 5, 6, 7, 3 inches in a month. That's just not possible. Yes, I do believe in extreme hair growth. I do believe in a faster rate of growth. But to me, I don't believe that it contributes more so to hair growth, because I just see my normal hair growth and everything is not going to work for me that works for you guys, and vice versa. Just putting that out there. Again, your hair may not react to the product the way that my hair reacts, so you guys do have to keep that in mind. But I honestly didn't see anything too extreme like the claims that people are making as far as thickness, because that also contributes to this challenge as well. I can say that I did notice a little thickness, and how can I tell that? Because I had a few more little edges to pull down. So whenever I do like a hair growth challenge, I notice that my edges, they do get a little bit more thicker. I'm not gonna say longer, because it's just like they fill in a little bit more. Like I get a little bit more hairs here. But when I'm not doing like hair growth challenges and I'm just like doing whatever, just using regular products, nothing additional for hair growth, that kind of like goes away. As far as thickness throughout my hair, I feel like if my edge hair got a little bit thicker, then more than likely the hair on my scalp would get thicker as well. I feel like that just goes hand in hand. Like my roots is already thick, so if they thick, then they just thick. But I'm gonna go ahead and do a little length check for you guys. As you guys can see, I blew out my hair because I have plans on straightening it after this video, so definitely make sure you guys stay tuned for the next video. But if you are trying this challenge and you are anticipating a above average amount of hair growth, definitely just don't be disappointed if you don't see that, because all the videos, literally all the TikTok videos, all the Instagram videos, all the YouTube videos that I've seen, with the exception of a few that say they didn't work, it doesn't for me contribute to hair growth. I can definitely tell you that. A lot of people, they were saying they also added black Jamaican castor oil in their mix. You can definitely do that if you're still interested in doing the challenge. I added the wild growth oil because that is an oil that I did read a lot of reviews on. People, they were saying that grew their hair faster and thicker as well. So I was like, if it's already reviews on a product that it helps with hair growth, why not just do that? I've used black Jamaican castor oil before, and for me it's just so thick and I don't really like the smell of it, so that's why I didn't use it. Really quick, I'm gonna do a little length check for you guys. I did take some pictures at the beginning of this challenge when I was braiding my hair, so that was October 6th. And please do not come for me and my little pictures. It was taken with my phone at arm's reach, and y'all know my hair is long and my arms are short, so please bear with me. We're gonna brush it out really quick. Y'all, my hair is huge. Okay, so we're gonna do the front part, and I cut my hair, you guys remember that. So it may be shorter in some areas. Let's see. This is the very front. And yeah, this is the part that I cut. It doesn't even reach the words here, and my necklace is here. So we're gonna try another part, like in the front-ish. And my hip bone, as you guys can see, is right here, and we right here. So microphone is here. So we're just under the hip bone. Hip bone is here and we're just under. And I'm ashy, so I'm sorry, guys. So we're here, hip bone, it's here. Doing like a check for my hair now as opposed to 2 months ago, I didn't really see a difference. If you guys notice a difference, then it's very small now. And I did it while my hair was blow dried because that's how I did my lymph check before, when my hair was blow dried before I did my braids. But what works for you may not work for me and vice versa. I'm sure there will be other challenges in the future that we can do and it's gonna work for both of us. But yeah, I do hope this kind of helped you determine if you wanted to do this hair growth challenge. So this hair growth challenge was a 3. I'm sorry, but that's what it is. I can't consider it to be a extreme anymore, so this is just a regular growth mixture. I do hope you guys like this video for the regular growth challenge with the Do Grow and Solver 8. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up, make sure you subscribe, and let me know what other hair growth challenges you guys have or think of or want to try. I actually have one in mind and it's kind of like the liquid biotin. So that should be a dead giveaway exactly what it is. It's something that you have to take orally. Let me know if you guys are interested. I will see you guys in the next one, and yeah.